In the original Meriden, there was a cycle of artifact lands released that were significant locations in the plane. Ancient Den, Seat of the Synod, Vault of Whispers, Great Furnace, and Tree of Tales, and they are regularly referenced in the Meriden artworks. During Meriden Besieged, you get to see those locations again in each of the Zenith cycle, and then you get to see their tragic remains in the next set, New Phyrexia, when each of the five lands has the remains of what happened to each of the artifact cities after they were compliated by the Praetors. Merch. Like. Comment. Subscribe. Hello. Welcome back to Basics, episode 13, a show where I take EDH commanders and try to find the perfect basic lands to fit them. I love seeing someone sit down with some beautiful basic lands, but something I love even more is seeing how well those lands match their commanders. One quick note before we begin. I like to give the artists credit for their artworks, but I may not pronounce the names perfectly. I'll try my best, but please forgive me and correct me if that ever happens. For number one, we've got Rankle, Master of Pranks, one of the mythics from Throne of Eldraine. While Rankle's illustrative and fairy tale styling is very akin to something you might see in Lorwyn, the thing that surprised me is that the basics from Lorwyn, Shadowmoor, or Morningtide were all too realistic to properly match Rankle's artwork, which is an amazing distinction. It's no small task to be able to distinguish the storybook style of Lorwyn from the Grimm's fairy tale styling of Throne of Eldraine. But after realizing that, I decided to expand my search to lands that match the greens and reddish browns with the more painterly focus. So take a look at this swamp from Unsanctioned, illustrated by Mike Birek, which has notes of the green, a mystical fairy tale aesthetic, and notes of the brown in the squirrel-shaped puddle of leaves in the bottom left corner. For another one, I really liked this swamp from Commander Anthology, illustrated by Jim Pavelek, which does an excellent job of matching the greens, painted brushstrokes, and high saturation that Rankle goes out of his way to exhibit. Second on the list, we've got Rune of the Hidden Realm, back from the early days of Commander products. The thing that sets this card apart is how pastel its colors are, and how directly it matches its color identity. There are intense whites and greens and blues all over in this artwork, and so the lands that we chose would have to match that contrast as best as we could. So I started off with this plains from the Cold Snap theme decks, illustrated by Christopher Rush, this forest illustrated by Pat Morrissey from the Cold Snap theme decks as well, and this island illustrated by Rob Alexander from the dual decks Merfolk vs. Goblins. It was a real treat to find these, especially the plains, which I feel matches absolutely perfectly. A second combination would be if you wanted to have more rendered illustrations and less painterly and impressionistic designs. So take a look at this plains from Throne of Eldraine, illustrated by Volkan Baga, this island from Lorwyn, illustrated by Warren May, and this forest from Lorwyn, illustrated by Steve Prescott. I feel like these three lands are from the time when artists moved from full paintings to digital ones, and with it, more focused and realistic depictions could be made into Magic the Gathering card arts, and eventually it became a part of overall MTG visual style. Next up, we've got a fun one that almost writes himself. Old Stick Fingers from Innistrad Midnight Hunt. In many ways, this artwork is pretty standard for Golgari-colored commanders, but the occult horror aspect is unique to just him. His head crest of bones and twigs, along with the thin and lanky frame, make him seem like he was summoned by some sort of pagan ritual. So I wanted to lean down that route by picking lands that make you feel like you're in a spooky forest clearing, getting ready to summon Old Stick Fingers. So take a look at this forest from the 2011 Magic Premier Shop promos that were released only in Japanese, and this swamp from the Seb McKinnon Secret Lair drop. I love these two paired together, because they almost appear to be the same dead tree. One is just closer to the frame than the other, and they both give off the dark greens and blacks that is quintessential to a Golgari-colored commander. However, for a more budget option, you could go with simply matching the overall painted aesthetic of Old Stick Fingers, with this swamp illustrated by Adam Paquette from Concept Harkir, and this forest from Innistrad Midnight Hunt illustrated by Andreas Rocha. Each of these places emphasis on the twisting and gnarling of a main tree in the foreground, and both come with color styling to help reflect the color identity of the other within their artworks and tie it all together. Third on the list, we've got Dakon Blackblade. There's a lot about Dakon that is unique. First, his design uses sharp line work. It has no traces of the blue tones or very many black tones at all, and is dominated by a strong yellow hue. And finally, Dakon's card frame is in many ways a large part of his aesthetic, because a player who owns a copy of this card will need to have this in the old school artwork from 1995. So, when searching for land, I felt that it was only natural to not recommend any suggestions that use modern card framing. So take a look at this swamp from Mirage, illustrated by Bob Eggleton, this plains from Arcadian Masks, illustrated by Dana Knudsen, and this island, illustrated by Terry Springer, from Arcadian Masks as well. I feel like this design really focuses on the yellows in his background and card frame, which ultimately makes it quite a bold choice. However, if you wanted to avoid the stark blue hues of the island, then you can take a look at this pairing that is a little bit more muted in its saturation. This island from Mirage, illustrated by Douglas Schuller, this plains from Odyssey, illustrated by Don Hazeltine, and this swamp from Tempest, illustrated by Brom. These all match the more pale yellow color that Dacon focuses on in his artwork while also not bringing in any unnecessary colors along with it. And finally, we've got a tough one. It's Agar, the Freezing Flame. Agar's color styling is remarkable because of how high contrast it is, while also being very dark in tone at the same time. And the combination of that deep navy blue alongside the orange of the lava makes him a very interesting commander to pick out card arts for. But I found three different art styles for him. The first going old school with this island from 2nd edition, illustrated by Mark Poole in his pink variation, and this mountain from 6th edition, illustrated by John Avon. I feel like the island, having notes of the red in it and the multi-tonal mountain gradient, is just amazing contrast that fits surprisingly well. But for a more modern set of cards, I wanted to focus on the deep blue that Agar has in his background. So take a look at this mountain from Commander 2018, illustrated by Alexei Bricklut, and this island from Shadows Over Innistrad, illustrated by Andreas Rocha. The dark blue hue of the island and the intense flows of lava from the mountain are both seen in Agar's art style and are very strongly contrasting, which in this case is a plus. For a third option, I went down the same rabbit hole, so take a look at this island from Innistrad Midnight Hunt, illustrated by Andreas Rocha, and this intense mountain from M13, illustrated by Rolf Ruppel. In many ways, they are just as good as the last pairing, although this one comes with the added benefit of the light blue color in the island that's present in Agar's left hand as he casts magic. For his alternative framing, I felt like it needed something more distinct to match his strong black tones. As with many of the other Kaldheim Showcase artworks, I feel like they match well with the Eternal Knight framed basics from Innistrad Midnight Hunt and from Crimson Vow. Specifically, this mountain illustrated by Daria Klebnikova from Innistrad Midnight Hunt, and this island from Innistrad Crimson Vow, illustrated by Rio Krisma, because they emphasize the contrast between the white and the black, and have fewer gray tones in them. However, I have another combination for the alternate framing of Agar, if you would indulge me. I wanted to highlight the colors in his artwork as well, and I noticed that alongside the dark black line work, there was a surprisingly pastel color palette in the blues and the reds, so I wanted basic lands that had strong line work, as well as focusing on that flat color. And I landed on this mountain from Kamigawa Neon Dynasty, illustrated by Ayami Nakashima, and this island from The Secret Lair of Astrology Aquarius Drop. The line work in the Kamigawa Mountain, as well as the red and the blue hued island, fits in many ways, even though it is a bit more expensive. But there you have it. Five more commanders sorted for which basic lands I think match them best. But I want to see what you think. Tell me which commanders you'd like me to try and pick up basic lands for. Comment below and let me know, and have a great day.